Our hometowns are under attack. Belvedere, Lordstown, Romeo. Just a few years ago, they were thriving towns with profitable auto plants.
Once incredible job-producing factories. What happened? I said, those jobs have left Ohio. They're all coming back. They're all coming back. Don't move. Don't sell your house.
The Big Three have closed 65 plants over the last 20 years. That's been devastating for our communities. Plant closers shutter local businesses, they wreck lives, and they rip apart families. That economy is cruel, and it's not working.
When Lordstown closed, catalyst for divorce, for myself included.
It's completely turned my life, you know, upside down.
It doesn't affect just your livelihood, it affects everything.
Knowing that, you know, I'm never going back to the community that raised me is definitely the hardest thing to think about. The plant's making money, we're chugging along. I went from working 7 days a week to being laid off.
This is a huge, huge corporate greed thing. You know, at what point is enough profits enough?
When we had the groundbreaking ceremony last year, we expected to go up to around 5,000 employees, and of course now we're in a position where we want to do that.
My dad was hired into GM in 1966, and it had been a great, prosperous community when GM came in. It really helped lift up the community and wages for people living there. When I got hired in 95, I kind of felt like I hit the lottery. Not only was it a great job, I was able to buy a house with a picket fence, raise two beautiful daughters, but was able to kind of live that American dream. We had three shifts there for a period of time, then it went down to two shifts, and then when they get down to the last nut, they say, oh, you know, we lost 1,500 jobs. That's not really accurate. It was closer to 4,000. And those were just the UAW GM jobs inside the facility. We represented a whole bunch of part suppliers as well. We had six different units. There was Teamsters, steel workers, and other IPS non-union facilities that lost their jobs when Lordstown closed.
For decades now, we've had an economy where one CEO has the power to ruin local communities. It doesn't have to be this way. In our contract talks with the Big Three, we're demanding the tools we need to fix this broken economy. We're demanding the right to strike over plant closures. We have to defend our communities from the corporate greed that's killing so many cities and towns. We're also demanding the creation of the Working Family Protection Program. It's a program that keeps UAW members working. If companies try to shutter our plants, they have to pay UAW members to stay on the job. That means UAW members providing for their families while helping out in schools, in nursing homes, and local parks. The Big Three will still make a healthy profit, and our communities will stay healthy too. We know our economy can work for the working class. We've seen it. When the UAW, the steel workers, and the Teamsters won big, so did families across the country. And that's what we're fighting for in these negotiations. We're fighting to rebuild our lives, our communities, and our economy. So join the fight.